Have you seen these mics around? Have you heard the term ambisonics and you're wondering what it's all about? Well, hi, this is Simon, and this video is a quick introduction to ambisonic audio. Ambisonic audio is actually first developed in the 1970s, but it's enjoying a recent resurgence because of the possibilities it offers in immersive audio for virtual reality and 360-degree video. Similar to 360 video, ambisonics allows us to create a 360-degree sound field that can then be decoded into a number of formats. Here in YouTube, for example, if you upload a 360 video with ambisonic audio, it's decoded into a stereo binaural file when the viewer watches it. What's neat about that, though, is the stereo file the viewer hears will correspond to the direction that they're looking. So just like a 360 video, viewers can interact and choose where they want to spend their attention. This is great, but how does it work? In order to understand what's going on, it's helpful to start by thinking about stereo. Most of the time when we record stereo, we use two microphones set up like this. When we play this back, one microphone goes to the left speaker and one to the right, and we get a stereo recreation of the sound. But did you know you can make a stereo recording with mics set up like this? This is called mid-side recording. What's going on here is one microphone, the cardioid, is recording the middle sound, and the other microphone, a bidirectional microphone, records both of the sides in a figure eight pattern. Since one microphone is the middle and the other the sides, we can't just put these in the left and right speaker. We need to do a little math, adding together these signals in order to decode the signal into the left and right speakers. So, with the mid-side technique, two microphones create one dimension of audio, left to right. For a 3D ambisonic recording, all we need now, in addition to left and right, is another bidirectional microphone for up and down, and one more for front and back. Now, most ambisonic microphones you can buy don't use bidirectional microphones. Instead, they have four cardioid microphones set up in a tetrahedral microphone array. The math of combining the four microphones is different, but the concept is the same. We'll have four audio tracks that we combine together to create a 3D image. When we're working with ambisonics, it's important to know a few terms to understand what format your audio file is currently in, and what kind of conversions it needs to go through before distribution and playback. The raw recording from one of these tetrahedral microphones is called A format. A format files are four-channel audio files that simply have the input of each microphone in the tetrahedral array. B format ambisonic files have gone through one stage of conversion, and the signals have been combined to create something akin to the mid-side recording. Only with the ambisonics, it's mid, side, up, down, front, back. These are actually given the names W for the center omnidirectional channel, X for the bidirectional front and back, Y for the left right, and Z for the up down. We also need to know that there are two kinds of B format, ambics and fuma, which order these channels in different ways and have different relative amplitudes. You can look these both up for more information, but what's most important is you understand what format you need to deliver in and make sure your files are in the appropriate format. YouTube and Unity 3D, for example, currently both want ambics files, not fuma files. In most any software that you use to convert your A format files into B format, you should be able to select either ambics or fuma, and you can also convert in between these two formats with ease. A warning: ambics, fuma, and A format will all just appear on your computer as four-channel audio files, so it's very important that you label them to avoid confusion and headaches later. Everything we've been talking about so far has been first-order ambisonics. You can use more than four microphones, more than four audio tracks to create higher-order ambisonics. These additional tracks help create a more full 360-degree sphere, filling in the diagonal dead spots between the microphones. Here's the waveform of a third-order ambisonic file, which contains 16 audio tracks. Now, for playback, all of these ambisonic files must be decoded. This is actually one of the great things about ambisonic files, the fact that they are not channel dependent. What this means is that an ambisonic file can be decoded into stereo, quad, or any number of speaker configurations. For many people, though, the most convenient way is to listen to a binaural mix on headphones. As I mentioned, in the case of ambisonic audio on a 360 YouTube video, you're also interactively creating the stereo output in real time based on the viewing angle within the 360-degree audio sphere. This means that each time someone watches the video, they'll have a unique sonic experience. This real-time decoding was perhaps not what engineers had in mind when developing this technology in the 70s, but it certainly helps the resurgence of interest in this 40-year-old technology for use in immersive and virtual environments. I don't claim to see the future, but I do encourage emerging artists and engineers to understand this technology, because it might hold some answers to contemporary and future audio challenges. This video is part of a series on immersive audio created in collaboration with Spectral Evolver. Go check out his channel, and if you're interested in immersive audio, please check out the rest of our playlist.